Speaking of calming down, are you worried at all about what took place on the floor earlier? The confrontation between Nieves, Trent Skaggs, and also Tilly?
Well, I wasn't here, so I like to tell them, you know, I'll leave for 20 minutes and everything falls apart. you know, I've talked to Brian, I've talked to Steve, our floor leader, and I've also talked to Skaggs. And, you know, they've apologized, and I think that, you know, Trent clearly said some things last night that you should not say on the floor. It was not good decorum, and he was gaveled down for it, and he quit saying them, and that caused some people to be a little upset. And then I think when Tilly made his speech about reminding everyone of decorum, Trent, you know, said some things in the back of the chamber there that upset Tilly, and then that, you know, it's Thursday. Rough late night, the night before, people, you know, I think everything's fine now. It's just one of the things, you know, you always have a few flare-ups, and they're all friends, and they all apologize, and I think everybody's, you know, good to go.
Are you worried about ramifications for the rest of the session?
No, I don't think so. I think you had one rep, and he said some things, and then it got a little heated between another rep, and now they've, you know, apologized and moved on.
You know, Skaggs' implication that I guess got gaveled down is a common sort of rhetoric point among Democrats. They say that since Sinkfeld gives Republicans and Democrats quite a bit of money, that they are sort of beholden to support issues that he supports. How come Democrats who make that are incorrect?
Well, I think, for one, you can't, because for one, you don't know what's in people's minds or hearts. Everybody in this building takes a financial donation for their campaigns. My question, if you wanted to ask the question, is why does Trent and many of the Democrats stand up and fight? Is it because the unions donate so much support and give to them and they made this their number one priority to kill? There's a question. No, I'm not going to say that's why Trent's doing it. I want to believe that Trent and many folks that were against us have legitimate reasons that they're against us, and they're logical reasons, just as many of us have for it. I personally was fighting for this issue back when I was in the minority, not autism, but it was scholarship tax credits for the inner city kids. And, you know, there wasn't anybody named Rex Sinkfeld in this state, and he wasn't writing any checks to anybody, and there wasn't anybody named All Children Matter. As a matter of fact, all we got was pain and grief from the education community. Not one dime came to us from anybody, but we believed it was the right thing to do. And I think what you've seen happen is people saw us, people like Rex, who have no financial stake in this, and they thought it was the right thing to do and said, I'm going to help those kind of people because they're pushing issues that I believe are the right course of action. That's why I and everybody else is pushing this issue. And I like to think that my counterparts that are against me are not against me because the unions are making it their number priority to fund their campaigns. They're against it because they disagree with the policy and doesn't think it's the right thing to do. And anytime you start on the floor, which is why Trent got gaveled down, anytime you make an accusation, and I've heard it done maybe 4 or 5 times since I've been in the House by both parties, say you're doing this because of that. You do not know what's in someone's heart or their mind, and you should never make that kind of accusation, particularly if you're taking donations too, because somebody could say the same thing about you. Yeah.